In the name of Allah, who is most beneficent and most merciful. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Fatima Nasir. I am from University of Education, Lower Mal Campus, Lahore. The subject is Evolution and Principle of Systematics. And today's topic of discussion is Micro Taxonomy. So let's start with today's topic. These are the some points which we will discuss in today's lecture. First one is Micro Taxonomy, then Classification System. Phenon, taxon, taxonomy categories, higher taxonomy categories, and infraspecific categories. Now, first of all, what is micro taxonomy? Micro means small, and taxonomy means division or classification of organisms into different categories, into different ranks. In 1975, Mayer and Ashlock first put forward the concept of micro taxonomy. Mayer and Ashlock gave the concept of micro taxonomy in 1975. And now the definition of micro taxonomy. Micro taxonomy deals with the study of variations, relationship, and characteristics on a small scale. As I have told you, the meaning of micro is small. So micro taxonomy deals with the things at a smaller scale. It deals only with the problems related to species. As we know that species is the lowest category in the hierarchical system of classification. That's why micro taxonomy deals only with the things related to species. Everything, every problem, everything related to species will be discussed in the field of micro taxonomy. One of the major problems micro taxonomy evolves around the concept of species. Many different concepts were given on the term species, that what is species, how different organism will form a species, and what will be the characteristics of species. So many different concepts were given on the term species. So micro taxonomy deals with all those problems related to the concept of species. Micro taxonomy involves the study of concepts of species like typological species concept, nominalistic species concept, biological species concept, and evolutionary species concept. As I have told you just now that many concepts were given to explain the term species. So these are the some different names of concepts that were given for the explanation of the term species. Now the types of taxonomy categories. Taxonomy categories are divided into seven major types. The first one is species. What is species? Species is a natural population in which organisms are resembled to one another, and they are also reproductive in nature. They can interbreed freely and can produce fertile offsprings. Here we have example of Mangifera indica and Panthera tigris. For example, term indica in Mangifera indica represent the specific epithet. What is epithet? Epithet is the second name in species. As we know that species is made up of two names. Now the first one is written with alphabetic capital alphabet, and the second one is written with small alphabet. The second name is called epithet. Each species has one specific epithet and one generic name. Number two is genus. Genus is a group of related species which resemble one another in certain correlated character. Correlated characters are those similar or common features which are used in delimitation of a taxon above the rank of species. In genus, many species which are resembled to each other are included due to the correlated characters. So correlated character is basically characters through which we can move from the species level to genus level, and we have much more variety of species in genus than species, because species is composed of one single population and genus have many more species. Number three taxonomic category is family. Family is a taxonomic category which contains one or more related genera. They have still less number of similarities as compared to genus and species. As we are going upward in the hierarchical or taxonomic categories, and I have told you in the previous slides that when we move upward from species level, we will have less similarities and more diversification. For example, genus Panthera, including lion, tiger, leopard, is put along with genus Felis in the family Felida. All the animals like lion, tiger, and cats have some similarities, but those similarities are not found in dog. Hence, it is placed in another family, Canida. So, all the animals like lion, tiger, cats, they will be included in one genus, that is Panthera. Next is number four, order. An order is a group of related families that exhibit a few similar character. For example, family Felida and family Canida are included in the same order, Carnivora, because the members of family Felida, which are a lion, tiger, cat, they also eat, they eat meat, and a member of family Canida, that is dog, they also eat meat. That's why they will put in one order, that is Carnivora. Number five is class. The class is a group of related orders. For example, order Primata comprising monkeys, gorillas, and gibbons are placed in class Mammalia, along with order Carnivora, which includes animal like tiger, cat, and dog, and they all having a common feature, that is hair on skin and milk glands. So that's why class is a group of related orders, because many orders can be summarized in the category class. Number six, Tibian or phylum. A phylum is a group of related animal classes. The term phylum is used for animals, while Tibian is commonly used for plants. Phylum term is used for animals and Tibian is used for plants. A Tibian or phylum is formed from one or more classes. Number seven is kingdom. It is the highest taxonomic category. All plants are included in kingdom Plantae, while all the animals are included in kingdom Animalia. That's why it is called the highest taxonomic category, because it only have two subdivisions. One is kingdom Animalia and the second one is kingdom Plantae. There are some other categories like subdivisions, suborder, subfamily, tribe, etc. But they are not regularly used. They are only used when they are needed. As we have discussed about them in the previous slides, only the seven taxonomic categories are commonly used. Other categories are used only when there is need of those categories. Now let's talk about higher categories. As we have discussed about seven basic taxonomic categories, the first one is kingdom. Kingdom is called the highest category, and the last category, that is species, it is called as the lowest category. And the categories between these two are called higher categories. There is no exact definition for higher categories. Taxa are based on zoological realities. Categories are based on concepts. In that respect, there is no difference between category species and higher categories. In some aspects, it is thought that there is no difference between species and higher categories, but in many other respects, it is said that there is a great deal of difference between concept of species and concept of higher categories. You can understand this point species, there is difference between species and higher categories, because in species only single population is included, only the animals or organisms of a single population that are closely related to each other. But in higher categories, we have less similarities and more diversification. So there is a difference between species and higher categories. Next point is, the category species is self-operationally defined by testing of isolating mechanism in nature. As we said that in species, organisms are reproductively isolated. They can interbreed with the other members of the species and can produce fertile offspring. The last point is the species category signifies singularity, distinctness and differences, because it have only one population, and that's why it signifies on the singularity, distinctness and differences of that particular population. While the higher categories have the function of grouping and ordering by not focusing differences between species rather than focusing affinities within group of species. Now we have infraspecific categories. Infraspecific name is the scientific name for any taxon below the rank of species. If we need to categorize any individual or organism below species level, then we will use infraspecific categories. There are also many types of infraspecific categories, which include number 1 varieties, number 2 subspecies, number 3 clines, number 4 rings, number 5 forms, superspecies, genus and race. These all are the types of infraspecific categories. Now we will discuss these categories one by one. First of all, what is variety? Variety can be defined as the group of population which is different from parent population. It refers to collective variations of local, geographical and ecological population. Means, in the term variety, the animals or the organism or the population will be different from their parent population because of their different localities. Because if organism from two different locations will interbreed with each other, then they will definitely produce a different form of organism. That's why variety, in the term variety, the offspring or the new population will be different from the parent population. Next is subspecies. The term subspecies came into general usage during 19th century, was a replacement for the term variety. Subspecies replaced the term variety. Subspecies is a group of population of species which are phenotypically similar but geographically isolated. Means, phenotypically means their phenotype, their physical appearance can be similar, but that organism will be geographically isolated. They may have from the different locations, and they can produce new species that are phenotypically related to each other. The next one is clines. A cline is the gradual change in the phenotypes and genotypes of a species across a geographical gradient. Means, with the passage of time, gradual change in the phenotype and genotype of species is known as clines. It will be clear to you by this example. When a species is distributed across a large geographical area, some of its members will occupy areas with slightly different environmental conditions than others. Allele frequency and traits might vary slightly across the geographical gradient because of different selection pressure. For instance, the coloration of these snails changes as you sample across their range. Means cline means that a very large geographical area, and the organisms are distributed in different parts of that geographical area. And if one part of that area have some different environmental conditions, then obviously the organism there will be slightly different from other locations of that area. So if you collect sample from different parts of that area, they will be changed from each other a little bit only, not completely. As you can see in this picture, these snails are different from each other in their color. due to the different geographical localities. Means the area was very much large and the organisms were distributed on that area. Due to different environmental conditions, different organisms with different color will produce. Now, what are rings? A ring species is simply a cline that is circular in shape, so that two ends of the cline overlap with one another. As in the cline, I have told you that a very large geographical area, that there is a very large geographical area and the animals or organisms are spread out on that area. So if one end of that large geographical area and other end, the both ends will overlap with one another, they will form a circle shape or ring shape, that is called as ring species. This produces two neighboring populations that rarely interbreed due to cumulative effect of the changes in genotype and phenotype along the cline. The both ends means if the area is very large and organism at one end and organism at another end, there is a very less chance of their interbreeding because of very large distance now. So if those two ends will interbreed with each other, then definitely changes in genotype and phenotype will be formed. For instance, the Larus gulls interbreed in a ring around the Arctic. There is a gradual change in genotype and phenotype, resulting in 7 different subspecies across the cline. Each of these different subspecies can interbreed with its regular neighbor, except for 1 and 7, where the cline loops back onto itself. As you can see in this circle, there are 7 different subspecies, which are formed by the interbreeding, of different parts of that particular area. Means the organism from different parts interbreed with their neighbors and they produce a variety of new subspecies, resulting in the formation of 7 new subspecies. It was about the rings. Now, forms. It is one of the natural term of taxonomy which is formed due to the variation found between the individuals of the same species. Means if the individual of the same species will show some variation, then that will be called as form. If for example, if we are talking about cats, one species of cats, and the cats between that particular species are showing some variation, that may be color variation, that may be eye color variation, skin color variation, any type of variation, that will be called as form. This term is used when we don't know whether the phenomenon is in question is full species or subspecies, or whether it is subspecies or any individual variant. For example, locust, it has two forms, solitaria and gregaria. They are morphologically different. It is not a valid taxonomic category. Means they both are, if we are talking about the two species of locust, they are morphologically different, but they are locust. Means they are from the same species, locust. They are from one species, but they are showing difference in their morphological appearance, in their body structure. Okay, and forms, it's not a valid taxonomic category, but it's the part of taxonomic category. That's why we have discussed it here. Now let's discuss the superspecies. Superspecies was introduced by Mayer in 1931. It is a monophyletic group, closely related and largely or entirely allopatric species. Monophyletic means the organism relate to one common ancestor. Various terms given by the eminent taxonomists regarding these categories are Formal carriers, it means array or collection of forms of the same species. Present carriers, Rens, he was a German scientist who used this term. It means array or collection of races of same species but found in different geographical area or different locations. Then atom carriers, it means array or collection of species. The next we have deme. A deme is a community of potentially interbreeding individuals at a given locality which share a single gene pool, that is they are genetically similar. Gene pool means the total genes of a particular area of or a particular community. That's why in deme, organisms who are interbreeding with each other, they are sharing one single gene pool. That's why they have similar genetic characters. Deme has been used to denote the local population of a single species. It has no taxonomic importance and it only have evolutionary importance. That's why it was rejected and nowadays it is not being used. Now the last point is race. Race is defined as a category representing geographical isolates, means the organisms that are located on different locations. That is a group of individuals which are phenotypically different and found as a distinct group in a particular geographical area. Means it form a group in which organisms are phenotypically different, but they have a distinct position or distinct group in a particular geographical area. It is not a recognized taxonomic category, and races are of two types. First is biological race. Biological race are those which are phenotypically similar but reproductively isolated. Means there can be any barrier between those species. That's why they are reproductively isolated but they are phenotypically similar. This is why they can also be referred as sibling species. Number two is ecological race. Are those races which differ in their ecological requirement. It is a valid category in botany. Means in ecological race, organisms need different organisms of the same species, or same species can need different environmental or ecological requirements. For example, savanna sparrow has two populations found in coastal areas and dry areas. One savanna sparrow, it has two population and which are found in two different areas. One is coastal areas and the other one is dry areas. It was all about today's lecture. Thank you so much. If you have any question, you can ask in the comments.